Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. In today's episode, I wanted to cover something that a bunch of people have asked me lately. How do I get started in knife making? What do I need? So I figured I would spend this time and just show you the basics of what I think you need to get started making your first knife. Let's take a look. All right, here's what I think is the basics. There's one more that I'll go over at the end. So first off, you're going to need some kind of forge. I built this forge, and when I started, and I've done other videos, you know, I'm a big proponent of, you know, build your forge, learn how to weld. I still think that's a really solid thing to do. You really should learn how to weld. But if you don't want to start there and you just want to start beating on some steel, there's lots of forges you can buy online for around the $200 range, sometimes less, sometimes a little more. So go get a forge. You know, I would recommend you get a two burner forge like this. You know, the one burner you just might find limiting. So go get something similar to this. This thing that I built will easily do forge welding if you ever want to do that. And you want to get something pretty small, get something you can block up the sides, or get some fire bricks that you can block up the sides to keep the heat in. So go look at some cheap forges. Lots online. Devil Forge, the Majestic Forge, the Mr. Volcano Forge. All of those are great. Next, you're going to need some kind of anvil. The reason I do the air quotes there is you don't really need an actual anvil. Get as big of a piece of steel as you can get. I think one of the things you should do is go to or look up your local steel yard. Go there and ask them what is the biggest drop of steel that they have. Maybe you could even have it. You'll get it probably pennies or tens of pennies on the dollar compared to actually buying an anvil. This is a 70 pound NC anvil, which I got shipped to me. I think in total, I think it's like $375 for this anvil, which is great. This is a farrier's anvil, normally for making horseshoes. So it's got some of these things in a hole, and it's got a hardy hole. Most of this stuff you won't need as a knife maker. You just want a big flat surface and some edges that you can use. So, you know, an actual anvil is kind of a nice to have. You just want a big block of steel, as heavy as you can find. Okay, so anvil. Next, hammers. Yes, you can spend hundreds of dollars on an actual blacksmithing rounding hammer. And I've got a good friend, Spencer, who made me one, which is my go-to and I use all the time. But this is what I started with. I went to Lowe's or Home Depot and I bought the $10, whatever it was, 3-pound hammer. And what you need to do is just round off one side here, and then on the other side you just kind of round the edges, and this way I've essentially made a rounding hammer. And you need the round side to spread metal and the flattish side to do, you know, to make it flat. So that's what you want to do. Another really good thing you want to do is do the same thing with a cross peen hammer. So round out this peen a little bit. And this is so you can spread a lot of metal, and I wanted a bigger hammer for some things. I don't use this one all that much. A 4-pound hammer's quite a bit. So go the cheap route and just reface your hammers from just a big box store. Next thing you're going to want to do is get yourself an angle grinder. This is just an essential tool. This is what you're going to want to use to cut out your stock. So buy stock, and we'll get into steel in a second. Just buy some stock steel, and you know, either you could even start with stock removal, okay, but obviously you want to start forging. So just buy some regular steel. You're going to want to be able to cut it and shape it in some sort, so you're going to want this. These things will get you forging. Okay, now to finish a blade, you're going to need some kind of belt sander. And what I would suggest for folks is to go out, if you're on a budget, go find a 2x42, which means a 2-inch belt by 42-inch long, is a really popular grinder.
a belt grinder. You can probably get them for $200-$300. Okay. Yes, you could start with one of these guys and get a disc like this. They're just not very accurate, and you will not have a nice product. You really need a belt grinder to finish a knife. So that will get you started. After you go beyond the belt grinder and you feel like you want to upgrade, this is when you might want to consider something like this. And this is the Broadback grinder. I consider it probably one of the top of the line grinders. It goes horizontal. It has all kinds of different features, different platens. So, you know, it was also, you know, it's closer to, you know, $2,500-$2,600. So obviously you want to, you know that you're going to continue in the craft here, but this is going to make your bladesmithing a lot better, of course. And then they also have their whole line of abrasives, so check those out as well. But again, that's not for necessarily for beginners. Go get yourself a cheap 2x42 and start there. So all in all, you know, the forge, let's say 200 for the forge. Maybe you get one of these at your steel yard, maybe for $100 or something like that. These you can pick up for $60. And then depending on how much you spend on your belt grinder, you know, you could be into it for maybe $600, somewhere around there. And that will get you all of the things you need, or the basic tools to make your first knife. If you just want to do forging and you're going to totally forge it to shape, yeah, maybe you get away without having the belt grinder, but you're going to need it eventually. There you go, folks. Let's talk about steel. So my recommendation for steel, if you can get some leaf spring from a car or something like that, that's a good bet for your first knife when you're playing around. Other than that, I would say bite the bullet and order steel from Jantz or some other one of the steel companies. They'll ship it to you. Jantz does flat rate shipping, $17. You can get a 36-inch piece, a 1.5 inch by 36 by 1/8. 1/8 is a little thin for forging, but you can go a little thicker. But you can buy 1/8 stock, 36 inch, for about $18. Okay, buy yourself two or three of those, and that'll last you quite a while. Maybe get some a little thicker. So, you know, that's what I recommend you start with. Of course, you're going to need some oil. You know, you can start with canola, but I don't advise that. I advise if you're going to get into it, buy some real quench oil. But canola will do you for a while. But certainly, that will get you started. That will get you beaten on some steel. And, you know, send me some pictures of your first knives, and maybe you'll see them in viewer knives. Thanks, guys. I hope you got something out of today's video. We'll see you on the next one.